Okay, now watch, I'm not playing. This was one of the top songs ever. Ever. Right? And I don't care what hip hop, if you a real hip hop head, you already know Eminem is a whole nother level. Now, if you just want to go on a cultural boy and be blind, you're not making him one of the top ever, but one of the top ever. And if you listen to the song, what he's talking about is execution. That's what he's talking about. That's why the song was so fire. We good, son? I want to show y'all something real quick, right? I've been studying y'all, for real. I've been studying y'all. I ain't playing. Look. Y'all better be grateful for Cole. Y'all better be glad for Cole. When he come back and he get up, y'all better give him a hand. Look, he ain't in here right now. When he get in here. Look, I'm being real with y'all. I was like, yo, $500. Like, I've been studying the game. I'm like, Cole was like, E, I know you wanted 300. But I said, bruh, I could have said $100 and got 1,000 people in the room. I'm not stupid. I should have charged $50 and the room would have been packed. They didn't even charge us a lot for the room. I could have did $50 and sold this sucker out. The stuff I'm giving, I'm not throwing my pearls at swines. I'm not interested in the numbers. So that's why I was like 500 at first, because I'm like, the smoke I'm about to give, I'm about to give some smoke. I'm about to change people's lives. So I want to show y'all something real quick. I ask you to do this, by the way, appreciate you, bro. That's some practical stuff that you could take and use this stuff. For real. And it took him years to do it. Now, what I know about some of you in the room, the yellow and the green, you don't like rejection. You're not built for conflict. So remember I told y'all the executor, the gorilla? I want y'all to look at the numbers. Only 12% of the world are natural executors. Only 12% of the world. And I looked at the numbers like, yo, that's kind of crazy, but I get it. They so demanding that if it was 50% of them, it would be crazy. If you had to deal with that personality, it would be a lot to have to deal with. 50% of the world is that, right? So less than 12% of the world are executors naturally. So what happens is they come in the room and they're not trying to be, you know, negative, but they sell you this stuff. They tell you to do this stuff and it's naturally in them. And then you go home and like, why can't I do it? Because they're not thinking about you and who you are as a person. So the reason why I put that music on, because some of you, it's going to be so hard to do. So when you get on the phone and you got to negotiate and you don't really like doing it, then you need to put the music on. Like some of you put it on, coach, when they're working out. But that's a workout. For some of you, negotiating conflict is a workout. So you got to put the music on before you call. Like, okay, let me get ready. Let's go. You got to be in the room like, let's go. I got to go talk to my dad. And I don't want to talk to my, how many of you got parents that you need to have a long, drawn out conversation with? You know what you need to say, but you ain't said it yet because you're struggling with conflict. Let me see your hand. For real, you know you need to have a conversation. How many of you got siblings that you need to have a conversation with and you ain't have it? Good. How many got business partners that you ain't really been truthful with, but you need to say, you got something you need to say, MCN? Good. How many of you have something that you need to deal with and you know what to do, but you haven't done it because you really don't feel like dealing with the conflict of it? Come on. I know who you are. 30, 28. So when you say it roll over my back, when you say like, yo, I hear no and it don't bother you, that's less than 12% of y'all. I'm giving you data. This data driven. This ain't something coming out. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not making this stuff up. These are the numbers. So for most of us, it's difficult. So the fact that it's difficult, it's okay. But now we're going to give you literal tools. So now you're like, yep, it's going to be difficult. But Coach Elijah, I just text CJ like, yo, we got to turn this into a program. People need this on demand. They need to be able to go back over this. Now, what I've done, because some of you, the seat style, y'all like, where the booklets at? You want everything, you know what I'm saying? So I just sent it to you electronically, you have it, all right? So when you go to your email later, it's there, you feel me? But what I didn't want was you looking at all of that while we trying to talk. You know what I'm saying? You like, oh, he gonna be talking about, what is he gonna be doing next? Like, I don't need that. So it's there, what he talked about is there, but we're gonna do it in a online demand so you can speak it out. so people can hear, because some people in the room are not structural. They can't read too much. It's too much stuff. So they just need to be able to sit back and hear it. So this is phenomenal. I appreciate you. So less than so you ain't got to feel like, you ain't got to feel bad. Like, E, I hate rejection. Welcome to the other 88% of us. Right? Like, you don't like rejection. Welcome to the other 88% of us. Only 12 people naturally can fool with rejection and keep going. But what you cannot do is you cannot be bound by these numbers. Just because you weren't born with it naturally doesn't mean you can't take your girl to California. Doesn't mean you can't buy her a high percentage of vitamin D pills and we hit it. It doesn't mean that you can't get her to exercise a little bit to get some of that, that's what's not natural, moving. It doesn't mean you can't change your diet and eat things that got more of the vitamin D in it. So I know you weren't, most of you in the room weren't born with it, but we're gonna spend the rest of the day and tomorrow we're gonna dig deep. We're gonna look at your personal, so how many of you, you're coming tomorrow and you took the test that I sent you, let me see your hand. You took the test. That test is gonna show me, are you yellow, green, or blue, and then we're gonna go to work. We're gonna go to work on it, all right? We're gonna go to work and help you to get to that next level. And this is only about business. This is, you need to execute in business. Some of you may need to execute in family. Some of you like got it going on in this area, but you're about to lose your marriage, lose your kids. So we're gonna walk through all of that. We good? Come on, I need some energy. We good? Come on, I need some energy. We good? But let me tell you what the problem is. Because you're either a yellow or you're either a green probably, right? So you care about others. And what you've done is that you've told them it was free. So now you're mad at them for what you told them. So now we got to reprogram. So when Cole was like, E, how you going to get the numbers? I was like, I'm going to charge $500. He's like, all right, well, that's too much on the first one. I know it's worth it, E, but you're taking them for getting free all the time. Like, you've conditioned the world for free, E. All your stuff is free. So now you tell me I got to pay $500? Like, I'm used to being free. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, all right, well, let's hurry up and condition them. Because the stuff I'm doing now, I know is about to change their life. Like, before, I was off of spirit and, you know, and my gift, but now this is scientific, right? You can't, the numbers don't lie. They are what they are. So what you're selling is free, but then you're hoping that at some point they gonna know to come pay. Right. That's not how you set it up. You said, and the reason why I know you set it up for free, because they think it's for free. They would have never thought it was for free. So what you probably are doing is saying, you know what? I'm going to give away this, and then you're gonna be mutual. And you're gonna wake up one day and say, I've done all this for you, now you're gonna be fair. You're gonna be fair. And you're just gonna come in and write me a check. And that's not how it works in business. You give it to me for free, I'm gonna keep trying to get it for free. So now what you have to do is you have to believe that the challenge is you believing that you're worth it. That's the real challenge. That you feel like what everybody else is doing, you're just as valuable in terms of your for real, that's where we go wrong. That's why they negotiating on us, because we don't know if we feel valuable, so we letting them negotiate with us. I'm not letting people negotiate with me no more. This is what it's called. Now here's where I will negotiate. If I know the relationship is mutual, and I know we going back and forth and we gonna look out for each other, I'll do whatever you want me to do. I just had a deal with Glenn. Glenn got me a deal, and I told my man I charge 50 grand. He's like, I ain't got 50 grand. How much? I was like, let's not play games. We're in a relationship. Glenn, tell him to tell me what he has. Why are we going back and forth? Let's not mess up our relationship. Just tell me what it is, and we're homies. I know you're looking out for my best interest. We good. But when you come to me and you're willing to pay somebody 50, but you're only going to pay me 20, then now we got a problem. Now I got to walk away, because I got to show you, you don't have to value me, but I do have to value me. You understand me? You don't have to value me, but I have to value me. And you're going to learn how to value me. So your real problem, when we take the test, I can help you a little bit better, because it's going to show me where you're adapting, right? And then I can show you, stop adapting here, stop compromising here, and you need to do this. But you're sending out a free message, and then the hidden message is, on the third time, I want you to pay. That's not fair to them. They should know the expectations up front. And you shouldn't be afraid if you tell them the truth and how much it costs that they're not gonna want it. You feel me? That's what you feel like. You feel like, I know, it's, the test is real. It's real. So I know, so you feel like, well, if I tell them $400,000, they're gonna say no. If they say no, then they're not your sheep. They're not your sheep in the first place. Your sheep know your voice and they will come running. Your sheep know your voice and they will come. You understand? So that's why I'm not on the internet going, it's 2 days left. Come quick, buy a ticket. I only want my sheep in the room in the first place. I don't want strangers coming in listening to me. I know how to get an extra 500 people to come in the room. That's not what I want. What I want is my sheep, because I'm gonna be able to help them. You understand what I'm saying? So you, girl, you go in there with knowing the value. You better start looking in the mirror. Give her your the affirmation things you do. I want you to start doing those, and you better look at yourself and say, I got it going on. You ain't cocky, but you confident. My program is good as everybody else. I'm not against nobody, but I'm Les Brown. I remember I was talking to Les Brown once, and I was telling Les, yeah, Les, you know, at some point, you know, Tony Robb, I was calling out all the names. Les was like, what? You way better than all of them. Have you lost your mind? Tony who? You Eric Thomas. You care for the people like nobody else care for the people. You're the best in the world right now. I was like, what? Say that again, Les. He was like, no, you the best. I got on the airplane like, you the best. Yeah, you the best, Eric, yeah. And not in a cocky way, like, yeah, you care about the people. Yeah, you're not gonna charge them an extra $1,500 to take a picture with them because it's not necessary. They already spent money. Why are you trying to rob them and get another $1,000 off of a picture? Yeah, you do care for the people. Yeah, you are, yeah, that'll be $50,000. Yep, that's $100,000, absolutely. Yep, you gotta pay for integrity. I'm not on my third wife. You gotta pay for that. You gotta pay for the integrity. You gotta pay for, I've been there for my kids. You gotta pay for the decisions I made. Yeah, you gotta pay for that. And if you don't pay 50 now and you call me tomorrow, it's 60. So you got 24 on the 50, boy. You call me tomorrow, I'm taking it up because you took too long. Scared money don't win. Are you feeling what I'm saying? So that's what you're struggling with, the confidence. I'm gonna need you to be real. Some of this stuff's gonna hurt today, but it's okay. One of the things I'm starting to realize is there's a small group of people that's really living the American dream. So they're selling you some good information. They're not showing you how to execute on those. All I'm saying is, as we move forward, we can't help certain things, but we're not gonna sabotage ourselves. I'm gonna show you why they execute and why you don't. But more of us could be living whatever life we want. But what they didn't show you is how you were supposed to do that. What I want y'all to start doing for me is having dreams and then give me a couple nightmares to go with the dream. For real, I just want you to make up in your mind like this could happen. Not because I want you to be spooked out, but I don't want you to get hit and you like, I didn't prepare for that.